Sometime in late 1953 or early 1954, a Brazilian man named Pedro Rodrigues kicked his pregnant wife in the belly. This wasn't completely out of the ordinary for Mr. Rodrigues. He had quite the temper, and Mrs. Rodrigues had been the unfortunate recipient of several beatings throughout their marriage. What couldn't have been known to Mr. Rodrigues at the time that he delivered that kick to his pregnant wife's belly is that it would have lasting consequences and would lead, ultimately, to his own blood-soaked murder inside a Brazilian police holding cell about 20 years later. On July 17, 1954, Mrs. Rodrigues gave birth to their son in their village of Santa Rita do Sapucaí, about 135 miles north-northeast of Sao Paulo. The baby was born with what was described as a bruised skull, an injury that came from his father kicking him in the head in utero. This injury, some have speculated, damaged the baby's mind, turning him to extreme violence. They named him after his father, Pedro Rodrigues Filho, or Pedro Rodrigues Jr. They called him Pedrinho, which is translated as Little Pedro or Petey. As Pedrinho grew up, he began to feel the appetite to kill. And at about the age of 13, he got his first chance when he got into a fight with an older cousin. He pushed the older boy into a sugarcane press, almost killing him. That feeling of failure, almost killing that older boy but not quite actually succeeding, must have been extremely difficult to bear. But not long after, he got another chance. When he was 14, his father was accused by the deputy mayor of Santa Rita of stealing food from the school where he worked as a security guard. He was fired. So Pedrinho took his grandfather's shotgun and shot and killed the deputy mayor in front of City Hall. Then he went and found the security guard who was suspected of being the actual thief and killed him too. Then he fled to Mogi das Cruzes, which is part of the metropolitan area of Sao Paulo. While he was in Mogi das Cruzes, Pedrinho began to rob and eventually kill drug dealers, taking over their turf to earn a living. He had established for himself a solid reputation for brutality when he found the love of his life, Maria Aparecida Olimpia, nicknamed Botinha. Everything was going well in his little empire. Botinha even became pregnant, and he was looking forward to having a family of his own. But Botinha and his unborn child were murdered by a rival gang. Seeking revenge, Pedrinho and four companions went on a torture and murder rampage to try to find the responsible assassin. They found the killer at a wedding party. Pedrinho and his crew killed 7 and wounded 16 people that day in their crusade to avenge Botinha and his unborn child. He wasn't even 18 years old. By that time, he was known as Pedrinho Matador, Killer Petey. While he was still in Mogi das Cruzes, Pedrinho learned of the death of his mother at the hand of his father, who had struck her 21 times with a machete. Pedrinho found him in a holding cell in a police station. He went in for a visit, stabbed his father 22 times, cut out his heart, chewed off a piece of it, and spat it on the floor. So on May 24th, 1973, Pedrinho Matador was arrested for the very first time. As he was being transported with another prisoner, he killed that man with his bare hands while both were handcuffed. When the police opened the back of the transport vehicle to see what had happened, Pedrinho took responsibility for what he had done, saying the man was a rapist and needed to die. Pedro Rodrigues Filho was sentenced to 126 years imprisonment. While he was in prison, he killed 47 of his fellow inmates. In total, he was sentenced to 400 years imprisonment. But Brazilian law states that nobody should spend more than 30 years behind bars. So in 2007, he was released from prison. Somehow authorities were able to figure out a way to extend his stay by about 4 years. In 2011, he was arrested again. According to news reports, he spent 8 years in prison for the charges of riot and deprivation of liberty. It's also been reported that he was convicted of the same charges in 2018. It's unclear from what I've read when he got out of prison the last time, but he did get out. Nobody knows how many people Pedrinho Matador actually killed. Estimates run from the low 70s to well over 100. But this we do know. Pedro Rodrigues Filho is now a free man, living in Fortaleza in the northeast of Brazil. But this is where it gets weird. Pedrinho Matador is now a YouTuber. If you take a quick look at his channel, Pedrinho es Matador com Jesus, which literally means ex-killer PD with Jesus, you'll find video content ranging from his baptism in a river, to hiking in the forest, to a video of a baby who he calls his grandchild eating a mango. All of it has deeply religious overtones. In one video titled, "Thank You, Pastor Julio, for giving me a new hope," he raps about his time in prison and his change from serial killer to ex-killer. Cruel com os inimigos, serial killer sanguinário, frio e vingativo. Só de ver Pedrinho, vagabundo se tremia. Dentro da cadeia, na cela ninguém dormia. O tempo foi passando, resistindo sempre forte. Hoje recuperado, pagou por todas as mortes. Chegou a lei dos 30, tá chegando a liberdade. Hoje um novo homem regressa pra sociedade. Depois de muito tempo, a liberdade chegou. Agora eu sou Pedrinho, ex-matador, levando a vida. When questioned if he killed more than 100 people, Pedrinho didn't know. He said, and I quote, "It might add up to that. Whenever I didn't kill anyone, I couldn't sleep." Pedrinho calls life before now his wartime period. He said, quote, "God has punished me a lot. I've been very bad in my past because people have also been bad to me." He claims not to regret the murders he committed, only that he entered a life of crime in the first place. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked it, I would really appreciate it if you'd click the like button. And if you want to see videos like this in the future, you might consider subscribing to my channel. You might also be interested in my other channel, Solve Crimes with Rick and Gavin. On that channel, my partner Rick and I do deep dives into unsolved crimes that we think that we can solve with your help. You can get more information on that at solvecrimes.tv. And if you want more information on me, please visit gavinfish.com. I'll leave a link in the description.